Good morning to all of you. The respected dignitaries on the dais, developers from RE and other sectors, print and electronic media, colleagues, friends. At the outset, I appreciate the EQ International for organizing this Suryacon Hyderabad 2017 conference to support and strengthen the renewable energy market in India, especially the southern area. The involvement of national and international stakeholders to showcase the efforts taken up by them and share the experience and knowledge to strengthen renewable energy market is very much appreciable. Telangana government has taken many initiatives and brought many innovative policies such as TS IPAS, Mission Bhagiratha, Mission Kakatiya, and also for promotion and development of renewable energy programs for solar policy 2015 also. We are proud to announce that our state became a role model to the country for such innovative thoughts and policies. Based on government policies to strengthen the renewable energy sector, TS REDCO earlier formerly is a NEDCAP, and then after bifurcation of the state, first it was named as Telangana New and Renewable Energy Development Corporation Limited, but afterwards what our chairman has taken decision that for TNR initial is difficult to just informing, conveying to the others. It has taken recently in the during the last board meeting that TS Telangana State Renewable Energy Development Corporation, TS REDCO, like with other TS GenCo, TS Transco, TS Discoms, like that, state government also has approved that one. In line with government policies, we are in a move towards utilizing vast solar potential and other RE sources in the state. In promotion to support the initiative, Solar Policy 2015 already has been placed, and wind power policy is also being expected very shortly. That has taken very long delay due to it has come to the final finalization of policy, but at that time that SECI has given one bid, competitive bidding. Again, at that time, now state government is rethinking and directed to make competitive bidding way policy for wind policy also. That is also almost, I think, this is the time. Recently, 2 days back also, discussions held with our special chief secretary. He has given some directions. I am expecting very shortly, by end of August, we can expect the wind policy also. Further, state government has aimed to add cumulative capacity of addition from solar 5,000 megawatt by 2022. Accordingly, PPAs are entered for cumulative capacity addition of 3,800 megawatts, which was expected to be achieved by mid-2019. Innovatively, state has taken up projects under distribution generation mode, identifying the feasible substations, which has been appreciated by Government of India. And recently, during the MNRE meeting also, what Telangana has taken initiative identifying the feasible substations, calling tenders and allotting projects by that mode, it has, PS Goyal sir has especially appreciated, and other states also has requested to take that kind of initiative, so that then that will be the helpful for the development of renewable energy programs. So as of now, we could able to complete 1388.79 megawatt of solar projects were already commissioned in the state, and almost this is by end of June 30th. This month also almost another 200 megawatts is being added, this one for this 1388 plus 200 megawatts during the July in 2000 megawatts we are expecting to commission. Already 100 megawatts already synchronized in Mahabubnagar district, and one more 100 also we are expecting that one. Currently the total renewable energy contribution from state is above 1900 megawatts cumulative, all biomass, co-generation, municipal solid waste, including all mini hydel and solar, wind, all including wind. With the support of Government of Telangana and Government of India, we are planning to significant capacity additions to the coming years by identifying the solar PV off-grid programs and on-grid programs, wind energy programs, biomass and municipal solid waste-based power generation programs also. Further, government is planning to develop and implement many innovative ideas in promoting renewable energy, including hybrid technologies such as solar thermal, solar wind, and energy storage technologies also. With the directions of Chief Minister, recently a team of ministers and officials also, along with concerned experts, visited China and studied innovations in renewable energy, and now planning to implement the possible measures for solar thermal and solar wind and storage technologies, particularly on storage technologies. Now planning to implement the possible measures that could be replicated or modified if necessary in the state. Now we are formulating and exercising the policy for solar wind hybrid also, along with wind policy. That is also we are expecting by end of August or September, I think, along with wind policy, solar wind also we are expecting it. State government is also giving top priority for promotion of solar rooftop systems and individual homes, and also for agriculture pump sets for farmers in large scale with the support of national banks and other funding agencies also. Actually, solar pump sets program almost in India, most of the states has been taken up, but in Telangana we could not take up that program, solar pump sets program, because of certain reasons. Recently, meeting also held in the chambers of Honorable Power Minister and the special CS discoms, and our recent MD also have participated in that program. Minister also have given some importance for that one and directed to take up in pilot basis for cluster based grid-tie agriculture pump sets. The board also has taken decision and funds also allotted to take up on pilot basis 2 clusters in SPDCL and 2 clusters in NPDCL. That is almost all. It has come to the final stage. Day back, yesterday also in MNRE, there was a meeting on solar agriculture pump sets for the grid tie. That is also is giving, they have circulated concept note, and yesterday they have taken up meeting in Delhi. They are also taking the opinions, views of all the state governments. And from our state also, our recent MD, yesterday he had in Delhi and he has participated, and our Telangana government concept also he has presented to the government of India. Further, that recently the state government has taken very good initiative and planning to reach downtrodden sections also for providing 300 watt solar home lighting systems. Because under that program nearly 50% subsidy we are getting from Government of India, and 30% we are planning to get. State government already has allocated funds, sanction and allocated funds also they have released some, and to take up 5000 numbers for the BPL and SCST categories. From TS Redco has already initiated that program, tenders also finalized, and financial bids have been to be opened, and it has to be approved very shortly, that one. That is also, actually government is planning to think every constituency wise, rural areas, this is the major concentration for the government is rural areas, where the power supply failures were occurring maximum, that areas government is concentrating that one. That is also, the state government is also providing subsidy and already released the funds, that we are having the funds with TS Redco. Now we are taking all the initiatives on that one. Next, for the state government is also giving, along with REA, renewable energy is giving priority for energy conservation activities also. TS Redco is also a state designated agency for the Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Is taking many measures for implementation of energy conservation activities. Under that, already now TS Redco has recently has invited tender for supply of 40 lakh bulbs to the at the affordable price to the common man's for the particularly in rural areas. We have finalized that one. Philips has come to the as a L1 that only 44 rupees of 9-watt LED bulb, 9-watt LED bulb with 3 years warranty. Now we are making further steps for distribution of that LED bulbs also. Similarly, state government is planning to implement the replacement of energy efficient inefficient street lights with the LED street lights. That is also we're taking, and some villages, 25 villages, they have given directions to take up on pilot basis and released in recent in the budget also funds were allocated and released that funds. Now we are taking them. That are the steps from TS Redco and government. These are the main programs. Along with regular programs, TS Redco is taking and the state government is also giving priority for majorly for 5,000 megawatts by 2022 under solar and 2,000 megawatts from wind. And solar wind hybrid projects also government is giving priority. Now they have directed us to make a policy and come forward with the proposals. Now we are under formation of that one. We are expecting very shortly, in the next week, we are going to submit to the state government for finalization of wind and solar wind hybrid policies also along with other programs. These are the initiatives we are taking from the state. I expect this seminar will accelerate and boost the promotion of renewable energy market in the state and nation. It is the earnest endeavor of our TS Redco to encourage the all stakeholders and support all the RE activities in the state, particularly for EQ, Suryacon Energy organizers, and thank you one and all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for a very enlightening speech. In fact, we've all heard a lot, and a lot of work is happening in Telangana. A couple of years back, when the two states were dividing, the entire nation was not very sure about how will there be the progress of not just solar, the entire infrastructure development in this region. And my sincere congratulations to the entire state government that they have, in a very short span of time, they have, you know, moved away this cloud from minds of people, and a new state has done wonders, not just in solar, but in other infrastructure area, infrastructure development area as well. So my special congratulations on behalf of the solar fraternity, as one of the biggest plants are located here. It is one of the most attractive markets for distributed solar, already in the top 5 solar markets of the country. So big round of applause, everyone, for the great efforts by the Telangana government. Now I would like to invite Mr. Abhilakh Singh from IREDA to have a presentation, and then I would request Mr. Pankaj Verma, Head Business Development Renew Power, to moderate the session further. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Prasoon. Mr. Prasad. Mr. Prasad, Mr. Sharma, Mr. Pankaj, and audience in the hall. Good morning to you all. Before coming to solar, I will just draw attention to the entire energy sector. Today, we have installed capacity of power 330,000 megawatt, out of which 57,000 megawatt is from renewables. If you take percentage, then it comes around 17% from renewables in a total energy portfolio. And this, now we come to a this, what is our targets? So that we very well know the targets for the country up to 2022 is 1,75,000 megawatt from renewables, out of which 100,000 megawatt is from solar, 60,000 megawatt from wind, 10,000 megawatt from biomass, and 5,000 megawatt from hydro. If we go by as usual, business as usual, then installed capacity by 2022 will be round about 5,55,000 megawatt, and the renewables will be around 1,20,000 megawatt, 1,75,000 megawatt. If we take this figure and the way progress is going on, it is expected that at least 5,55,000 megawatt, 5,25,000 megawatt will be the capacity by that time. And if we take 1,75,000 megawatt, then it will be 33% of the total energy portfolio, and which is from 17% now to 33%. Another report last week I read for specific purpose, that was actually CA report, and beyond 2022, to 36, there is a 14-15 years plan. According to that, if we go by 2027, because they have taken a 5 years, and then last 3 years. By 27, this capacity will be 7,50,000 megawatt, and the renewables is expected to be 33% again. And thermal will come down to 52%, which is now today, it is 67%. And hydro almost constant to 12 to 13%. And if we go by further 32, then it is a 10,47,000 megawatt. And further go to 36, then it is a 13,37,000 megawatt. So this is the energy scenario in the country. With this now, coming to this, how actually our target is decided for renewables, then we have to go back little in number 15, where COP 21 in Paris was held, where the government of India or India has actually given some commitment, international commitment. That is what? That by 2030, we have to reduce our emission, carbon emission, by GDP of 2005 level to the extent to 33% to 35%. And the other point is, by 2030, the contribution from renewables should be 40%. Though just minute before I said 33 by the CA report, most likely CA report must have been prepared little 6-7 months back, so that they have put actually 33. Otherwise, it is a 40%, that is our target for the installed capacity. Of course, if you go by energy generation, that may be little less. Then coming back to this, our now target is set. We have an international commitment, and now we have to plan accordingly. So now 175,000 megawatt the target right now. So take 100,000 megawatt, which is now today's topic, solar. So solar, this 1,00,000 megawatt, 100,000 megawatt, it is further divided into 60-40. 60,000 is to come from grid connected, and 40,000 megawatt is to come from solar rooftop. But the government further taking a decision because of the rooftop going slow, so that 20,000 megawatt has been reduced in the solar rooftop, and now it is added to the park. And it is a, this park, solar park scheme is really very nice, where the government, state government is taking care, or any other organization like NTPC or SECI. So there are number of parks, solar parks, and the infrastructure being developed by the state government. And then the through reverse bidding method, these bids are invited from the private developers, private or even the public sector companies. And now, because of this, the solar price, cost of solar has come down drastically. That was 10 rupees 95 paisa in 2010, which is now came down to the level of 2 rupees 44 paisa. And if it is compared with the average average purchase of pooled price, then it is 33 paisa, 3 rupees 30 paisa. And if you compare, then 24% is lesser than the thermal power or power being purchased from the all sources. So now there is an opportunity for us that we can go further, and the private developers, and there is a lot of opportunities to invest in this sector. Now further, one more report I gone through last week that was very interesting. Now that was actually by 2018, the price of to the consumers, it is a 5 rupees 33 paisa, and few years later it will be 5 rupees 75 paisa. I think it is a 2022, and then further after 5-6 years it will be 7 rupees 50 paisa, and further it will be around 2030 or 2032 it will be around, expected to be around 10 rupees. And whereas price of solar is going continuously, maybe because of many other factors, some innovations also, maybe technological development also, because now throughout the world there is a research going on, and every day we are, or every now and then there is a enhancement of the efficiency, so cell efficiency, and of course then modules and overall power efficiency. So that definitely performance ratio of the solar power plant will further improve, and so on. And the price is expected, and the report says the solar price further may go down up to rupee 1 rupee 50 paisa. So though it looks 1 rupee 50 paisa is a very low, but the way price have fallen down over last 1.5 years, then nobody thought of that price will go so further. So I think it was 4 rupees 34 paisa in this Telangana or Andhra, Kurnool. And then it 315, then 330 it has come, 315 it has come, and then this Riva solar power project, that was 2 rupees 97 paisa in a first year, and thereafter 3 rupees 15 paisa or 30 paisa. And then further it surprises, this 2 rupees 64 paisa, 60, and then further Badla 3 and 4, it is 2 rupees 44 paisa. It was now wondered how they are managing and how it will be done. So in fact yesterday we have an internal training course, so we were just discussing, and then the trainer PwC, they were asking ki how this, then actually we have received the proposal, but not formally, not a application, but they have given a fair idea how actually they are achieving 2 rupees 44 paisa. That is precisely right. And yesterday one report I while in the flight I read in Economic Times that Andhra government from Kurnool, this power plant, solar power plant, they requested NTPC that they can take the power elsewhere, and they will not charge any transmission charges. So now this is the actually situation in the market regarding this energy. Now just coming to this, if you take this last year's generation, that is I think 1135 billion units from all sources, and if you take that per capita of our population, 134 or very close to 135 crore. So then this per capita is coming around 1,074 units. So it is still very, very less actually, far below with the average of world consumption, that is 3,000, 2,800 or 3,000 units per per capita. So now we definitely, we have a lot of scope that we can increase per capita consumption, and definitely then it cannot be alone by the domestic, this thing. Domestic is only 22 or 23%, whereas industrial is 44%. So we have to actually increase industries, more and more actually we have to put industries, and that is also Government of India's scheme is there, that is a Make in India. So under that also a lot of things happening, and we know, I think $55 billion have been committed in this. So that is also huge money, and lot many industries are coming. So definitely this over the time power consumption will keep on increasing, and our hopefully this consumption will be not definitely for 3000 or world average, but at least 1500-1600 units per this per capita, and with this lot of opportunities actually come forth.